She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus and America too. She's a good girl, crazy about Elvis, loves horses and her boyfriend too, yeah, yeah. It's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway running through the yard. I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart, and I'm free. Free falling, falling, and I'm free. Free falling, falling. All the vampires walking through the valley, they move west down Ventura Boulevard. And all the bad boys standing in the shadows, and the girls are home with broken hearts, and I'm free. Free falling, falling. Now I'm free. Free falling, falling. Free falling now. 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 Free falling. I wanna glide down over my heart. I wanna ride her name in the sky. I wanna free fall out into nothing. Oh, I'm gonna leave this world for a while. Now I'm free. Free falling, falling. Now free, free falling, falling. Now free, free falling, falling. Now free, free falling, falling. Free falling, falling. Free falling, falling. Free falling, falling.
Thank you very much. We'll see you in a few minutes.
But I still need love, 'cause I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. Darling, stay with me. Why am I so emotional? No, it's not a good look, need some self-control. Deep down I know this never works. You can lay here with me so it doesn't hurt. Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. Now here you go again, you say you want your freedom. Well, who am I to keep you down? It's only right that you should play the way you feel it. But listen carefully to the sound of your loneliness. It's like a heartbeat drives you mad in the stillness of a memory. What you had, what you lost, what you had, what you lost. Thunder only happens when it's raining. Players only love you when they're playing. I say women, they will come and they will go. When the rain washes you clean, you'll know. Now here I go again, I see the crystal visions. I keep my visions to myself. It's only me who wants to wrap around your dreams. And have you any dreams you'd like to sell? Dreams of loneliness, it's like a heartbeat drives you mad in the stillness of remembering what you had, and what you lost, and what you had, and what you lost. Thunder only happens when it's raining.
come and they will go. When the rain washes you clean, you'll know. And thunder only happens when it's raining. Players only love you when they're playing. I say women, they will come and they will go. When the rain washes you clean, you'll know. You will know. I will know. You will know.
You got a fast car, I want a ticket, you anywhere. Maybe we make a deal, maybe together we can get somewhere. Any place is better. Starting from zero, got nothing to lose. Maybe we'll make something. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove.
Got a fast car, I got a plan to get us out of here. Been working at a convenience store, managed to save just a little bit of money. Won't have to drive too far, just cross the border and into the city. You and I can both get jobs, finally see what it means to be living.
See, my old man's got a problem. He lives with the bottle, that's the way he did. Said his body's too old for working. Said his body's too young to look like his. My mama went off and left him. She wanted more from life than he could give. I said somebody's got to take care of him. So I quit school and that's what I did.
You got a fast car, but is it fast enough so we can fly away? We gotta make a decision. Leave tonight or live and die this way.
I remember we were driving, driving in your car. Speed so fast, felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone.
You got a fast car. We go cruise and entertain ourselves. We still ain't got a job. You know, work in the market as a checkout girl. I know things will get better. You'll find work and I'll get promoted. We'll move out of the shelter, buy a bigger house and leave.
You got a fast car. I got a job that pays all our bills. You stay out drinking late at the bar. See more of your friends than you do your kids. I always hope for better. Thought maybe together you and me find it. I got no plans, I ain't going nowhere. So take your fast car and keep on driving. I remember we were driving, driving in your car. Speed so fast, it felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice round around my shoulder. I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. You got a fast car, but is it fast enough so you can fly away? You gotta make a decision, leave tonight or live and die this way.
Coming out of my cage, doing just fine. Gotta be down. Want it all like this. Only a kiss, it's only a kiss.
Well, good afternoon, everyone, and on behalf of everybody here at Myerscough College and University Centre, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to this afternoon's ceremony. Today is, of course, a celebration of our graduate success, the class of 2022, and we also extend a very warm welcome to Ben Hobday, our new Honorary College Fellow. More about Ben in due course. Now, before proceedings commence, could I ask to double check that everybody has their mobile phones switched off or at least on silence out of respect for the ceremony this afternoon. A few other bits of housekeeping before we get proceedings underway as well. Fire exits, they are located at the side and at the rear of the hall. We're not expecting a fire drill this afternoon, so if you do hear the alarm go off, we all need to be leaving by this door to our left-hand side, and our evacuation point is on the visitor's car park just by our student bar, the Stumble Inn. We're also a no smoking campus, only in designated areas. Again, the nearest shelter is away through the doors to my left-hand side. It's not too bad in terms of the hotness and the warmth today, but if you are feeling a bit uncomfortable and you do need some assistance, if you just raise your hand, a member of our fabulous team will be with you in a flash. Toilets and first aid, they are in the foyer, which you'll find where you came in through the back doors there. So to the ceremony itself then, we'll shortly be welcoming our platform party to the stage. Our Chief Exec and Principal, Alison Robinson, will address us all. We'll also be hearing from the Chair of the Myerscough Corporation, Alan Foster. After the speeches, it's all about our graduates. They are the reason that we are here today. We're also incredibly proud of what they've achieved, and we hope they have a fantastic day celebrating their success. So here's how it will work. They will be called up one subject area at a time. They will line up on this beautiful ramp away to our left-hand side here. They will have their names called out one by one, and when it's their turn to walk across the stage, they will process serenely, smoothly, calmly. There will be no trips, there'll be no falls. Few people fell off the stage this morning, but don't let that worry you. It'll be fine, I promise. You will then head over to the right-hand side. You'll see a magic X, or it's actually a bit of yellow tape, where you'll stand and you'll be presented with your scroll and have your photograph taken as well. If you are a prize winner, you'll firstly stand on the magic X just in front of my lectern here. You'll turn and face the audience whilst I embarrass you for a few seconds whilst reading out your citation. Rapturous applause is, of course, anticipated and fully expected throughout, from the first to the very last graduate. That would be really appreciated. And of course, when it's your loved one's turn to shine, you can cheer, you can whoop, you can shout as loud as you like. Again, that is also actively encouraged. Graduates as well, when you return to your seats, you'll go back across to the right and then back to your seat. If you could be quiet also, of course, out of respect for the rest of the graduates who are still to receive their awards. So to begin proceedings this afternoon, we have a very talented vocalist. Ladies and gentlemen, please may I introduce to you the fantastic Gemma Louise Doyle.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. Imagine all the living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion. Imagine all the people sharing all this world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you can join us, so this world will live as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you can join us, so this world can be as one. The world will live as one. The world can be as one. I'll sing it one last time for you. Then we really have to go. You've been the only thing that's right in all I've done. And I can barely look at you, but every single time I do, I know we'll make it anywhere away from here. Light up as if you have the choice, even if you cannot hear my voice, I'll be right beside you, dear. And we'll run for our lives. I can hardly speak, but I understand why you can't raise your voice to say. To think I might not see those eyes makes it so hard not to cry. And as we say our long goodbyes, I nearly do. Ooh, oh. Light up, light up, as if you have the choice, even if you cannot hear my voice, I'll be right beside you, dear. Louder, louder, we'll run for our lives. I can hardly speak, but I understand why you can't raise your voice to say. Oh, 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 oh.
Gemma Louise Doyle. Gemma, thank you so much for a wonderful start once again to our ceremony, and you'll be hearing more from Gemma at the end of proceedings this afternoon as well. Let's get things underway then, shall we? Please, now, everybody be upstanding, but remain silent for the opening procession of the College Mace. Please be seated. Everybody on the platform party there, no resignations so far. That's great to see. I'd like to now invite Alan Foster, the chair of the Myerscough College Corporation, to say a few words. Alan.
A warm welcome, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, and of course, far more importantly this afternoon, our students and your families and your friends. My name is Alan Foster, and I have the honor of being the chair of the Myerscough College Board of Governors. We come together today to celebrate your achievements. I'd like to extend a warm welcome to our honorary college fellow, Ben Hobday. We'll hear more about his considerable achievements a little later. The ceremony this afternoon is about your success, recognizing your great results, and providing your family and friends with the opportunity to celebrate your achievements. It's particularly appropriate to celebrate these achievements given the circumstances of the last 2 years and the disruption that the pandemic has no doubt caused for you. Let me quote an unexpected source who I think summed up the reason for Myerscough and your education very well. He said, "Success is no accident. It is hard work, perseverance, learning, studying, sacrifice, and most of all, love of what you are doing or learning to do." This was said by no less an educator than Edson Arantes do Nascimento, the most famous footballer of my generation, more commonly known as Pelé. Not necessarily one you'd hear quoted in educational theory. If you've never heard of this Brazilian genius, look him up on Wikipedia. Your formal qualifications are the foundation on which you build your future, your aspirations, and your achievements. I would like to invite Alison Robertson, Myerscough's chief executive and principal, to speak to you.
Thank you, Alan. College Fellow, Chair, Governors, staff, graduands, parents, family, friends. I'd like to welcome you all to this very special celebration of the achievements of our higher education students sitting before us. I'm pleased to welcome our honorary guest, Ben Hobday, to these celebrations. I know Ben joins with me in congratulating you all on your achievements. I'd like to give a huge thank you to Ben on joining us today to receive his honorary fellowship of Myerscough College and University Centre Myerscough in what is a very busy time of the year in the international eventing schedule. Ben, can I please ask you to step forward? Ben Hobday was born and raised in Rossendale, Lancashire, and currently resides in Yorkshire. Not sure about that. He started riding when he was four, and his early competition experiences include the show ring with a first ridden win at Ponies UK. Ben went to work as a working pupil for eventer Hannah Bate in Cheshire, and then went on to work for William Funnell after Pippa Funnell offered him a role at their Surrey base when he was just 17. In 2006, Ben won the under-21 national championships at Upton's Hoo, and at age 18, he was selected as the British Young Rider squad, which culminated in team gold and individual bronze at the Young Rider European Eventing Championships in Crewe. Ben gained fame in 2008 after winning a gold and bronze medal in the European Championships, and went on to have winners at every national level, from pre-novice, introductory, novice, intermediate and advanced. He's been national under-21 champion, national novice champion, national British Open champion. More recently, Ben won individual silver and team silver for Great Britain in the Nationals Cup in Poland, which resulted in him being long-listed for the European Eventing Championships in 2019. And last year, Ben was long-listed for the Olympics and Europeans with his top horse, Shadowman Fiji. He's ridden a huge variety of horses at five-star events, with many of them being home produced. Besides competing, Ben is also a businessman and owns Shadow Sport Horse Limited, where he trains events horses. Ben is incredibly popular in the equine world, with over 100,000 followers on Instagram. No doubt helped by his TikTok dances and Take Me Out horse style spoofs. If you haven't seen it, you really have to Google it. I mentioned it to Ben over lunch, and he sort of denied this. He couldn't remember producing this Take Me Out video where he gets two horses dating. You really have to see it. He once said, "Life is short, and you have to enjoy every minute. Hard work and push boundaries. If you want to do something, do it now. What's the worst that can happen? And if you're not doing what you love, you're wasting your time." I think Ben's got a really good point. We're delighted to have Ben with us today. So, Chair, I present Ben Hobday for an honorary fellowship in recognition of his outstanding achievements in the field of national and international eventing. Congratulations, Ben. Ben had threatened to video this moment and do a little TikTok for us, but he hasn't done that. He's behaving. Just the tie to go back in. Well done, Ben. I'd also like to formally give thanks today to Myerscough's hugely talented floral design staff, who have regularly been awarded the British Floristry Association Training Provider of the Year. And they, together with the corporate services team, have carried out the transformation of the sports hall for this very important occasion for our students. I'm sure you'll agree that the flowers in here look absolutely stunning. For the first time, for the first time in the 128-year history of the college, we have students graduating this week from three different academic years due to the pandemic. I'm therefore delighted to welcome to this ceremony our graduates from the class of 2022, to our award ceremonies. It's been a very tough 2 years for everyone around the world. None of us expected to be living through and dealing with the consequences of a pandemic in our lifetime. We know it's been incredibly hard for our students and staff, as well as the families. We're incredibly proud of how all of our students have adapted to studying in bubbles on campus, following our health and safety measures, like wearing masks in class, which we know was really hard for everybody, and switching between online learning and face-to-face learning. We know it has been incredibly challenging, but the resilience that you have shown and the friendships that you have made will stand you in good stead and provide you with a lifetime of memories and the courage to tackle absolutely anything that life in future might throw at you. Of course, some of our students had planned to study their degree online, meaning Myerscough was uniquely placed to support our students during the past 2 years. Today, we're delighted to welcome students to campus, those who completed their degrees face-to-face with us, but also many who studied full-time online with us, some of whom travelled here today from places as widespread as the Netherlands, Hong Kong, Ireland, the Falkland Islands, and more. So welcome particularly to those attending college here today for the very first time. This morning's graduation, even this afternoon's graduation ceremonies, will see our students from agriculture and countryside, equine, teacher training, veterinary nursing, and farriery graduate. Students are at the heart of their college and university experience, and it's so much more than simply academic qualifications. At different points during the past year, our graduands in front of us have been able to participate in a wide variety of opportunities, from high-quality work experience, sporting and non-sporting competitions, our research conference, guest speakers, employer visits, graduate showcase, community work, charitable fundraising, peer teaching, learning assessment, injury skills development, and not forgetting the social events at the Stumble Inn and Old Nell's. All have been critically important in creating a broad-based higher education for our students. Our academic activities have led to high levels of achievement amongst our students, with 97% of students progressing into employment or further study after graduation, placing University Centre Myerscough amongst the very best. Today is a day to celebrate, to recognise the hard work and commitment that has gone into the past years, and to congratulate all of our students on their successes. It is a time for every student to walk tall, smile and shine as they walk across the stage and proudly graduate from University Centre Myerscough and the University of Central Lancashire. It's also an opportunity to thank parents, families, friends and the Myerscough team for their contribution to this achievement. On behalf of the students and the college, I'd like to personally thank you all for the part that you played in supporting our students. And I'd like to ask the students to please give a round of applause to their families, friends and staff who've supported them on their journey. Finally, to our students, think of today not as an ending, but as a beginning. Your success in your studies here at Myerscough has equipped you exceptionally well for the future. You have overcome so many obstacles during the last couple of years that this should give you the courage, the self-belief and determination that you can go on and do absolutely anything in life. So whatever your next steps, the Myerscough team wish you a very happy, healthy, fulfilled and successful future. Good luck.
Alison, thank you very much indeed. Congratulations to Ben as well. And Ben, if you'd like the video footage of yourself being presented with your hood, we are live streaming this event as we speak. I can send that to you after the show, no problem at all. I look forward to the TikTok. Honorary College Fellow, Chair, Governors, Principal, honoured guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, I have great pleasure in presenting to you today the University Centre Myerscough students who are graduating and receiving their awards. Some are unfortunately unable to attend because of other commitments, holidays, work and so on, but of course they will all receive their awards in due course, and we offer their hearty congratulations to each and every one of them too. As Alison alluded to, this afternoon's ceremony celebrates our 2022 cohort in Agriculture and Countryside, equine studies, teacher training, and veterinary nursing and farrowery curriculum areas. As our graduates make their way to the stage, we'll take a few moments to share some video footage to showcase each of the curriculum areas. And as I alluded to a little earlier on in the event, rapturous applause throughout, cheering, whooping, that all is actively encouraged as the graduates proceed across the stage. The first subject area this afternoon of which we are celebrating success is agriculture and countryside.
Myerscough is one of the leading institutions for agriculture in the UK. Our courses prepare students for a career in the industry by combining relevant background skills with the knowledge of crop and livestock technology and business enterprise. There is currently a significant demand for highly trained and well-educated professionals to enter the agriculture industry. This demand for skilled staff has also been fueled by the increasing awareness that food production, farming, tourism, the environment, and rural affairs are all interconnected. This has created a need for motivated and technically competent people who understand the requirements of agriculture and its related industries. Myerscough's Food and Farming Innovation and Technology Centre, opened in 2018, is a centre of excellence to develop state-of-the-art precision farming techniques within the livestock and grassland sectors. It incorporates specialist teaching, demonstration and research facilities, including a livestock innovation centre and the latest grassland equipment, feeding technologies, hybrid tractor power units and field trials equipment. It's estimated an additional 60,000 highly skilled and qualified people over the next 10 years are required in the industry. To take on this challenge, Myerscough's learning combines both practical and theory skills in the sector to prepare students for a career in the sector. Myerscough's courses help students develop knowledge alongside technical, practical, and employability skills, developing a thorough understanding of the current issues and challenges in the farming industry. Agriculture graduates at Myerscough go on to a range of careers in the industry, including farm management, livestock specialists, business advisors, breeding specialists, and animal nutritionists. The management of land for the conservation of flora and fauna, general recreation, environmental education, and urban regeneration requires a blend of skills. These include an understanding of ecological principles, a sound knowledge of management, and the practical ability to carry out conservation techniques, from river catchment systems to rural and coastal habitats. Countryside students go on to a range of job opportunities within the conservation, gamekeeping, and commercial sectors, such as countryside ranger, ecological surveyor, farm conservation advisor, education officer, and fisheries manager.
And we begin this afternoon with the BSc Honours Programme in Agriculture and our first graduate, Lauren Barton. Our scrolls this afternoon are being given out by our Vice Principal and Deputy Chief Exec, Stephen Downham-Clark. Our next graduate, Kirsten Evans. George Hall. Thomas Hesketh. Thomas Waterworth. Matthew McLean wants our next graduate. You are a prize winner, Matthew. Come and step onto the Magic X. Tutor's comments. Matt has graduated with a well-deserved first-class honours degree. He's always worked hard and gone the extra mile throughout his studies and has been a pleasure to teach over the last 3 years. Matt has shown excellent leadership skills by initiating an all-expenses trip to the NFU conference for both him and his peers, where they represented both themselves and the college extremely well, with compliments from NFU Regional Director David Hall. Matt's participated in national competitions and has won the RABDF Farm Health Planning Competition. He was also runner-up in the Dairy Student of the Year. Matt has a very bright future ahead and has already secured a graduate job. We'd like to wish him well for the future. The winner of the 2022 Lancashire Cheese and Dairy Cup is Matthew McClymont. Lift it above your head, Matt, like the FA Cup. We move on to the BSc Honours Programme in Agriculture Livestock Science, and Emily Holden. The BSc Honours Programme in Rural Resource Management now, and Richard Mossen. Matthew Wathay. Bethany Bradshaw's our next prize winner. Beth, if you'd like to step onto the Magic X, please. Woo. Tutor's comments. Beth completed a foundation degree in ecology conservation management back in 2019 and then successfully progressed onto the BSc Rural Resource Management degree programme. The award today is recognition of how well Beth has excelled throughout her time at University Centre Myerscough. She's been a pleasure to teach and has worked well with her peers on the course. We would like to thank her for her hard work and efforts throughout her time here and wish Beth all the very best for the future. The 2022 FitzHerbert Brockholes Cup goes to Bethany Bradshaw. Well done, Beth. And the next subject area we are celebrating success this afternoon is equine studies.
The equine industry in the United Kingdom is expanding rapidly, with a turnover approaching £1 billion per year. It encompasses many different sectors, supported by a large ancillary industry, which provides extensive career opportunities. Myerscough is well known as one of the leading equine centres in Britain. The facilities and expert knowledge of the tutors provide an ideal learning environment in both teaching and research. The equine department at Myerscough has excellent resources, including a busy international equestrian arena, indoor and outdoor schools, motion analysis software, a cold water therapy spa, and specialist laboratories. As well as this, there are dozens of quality horses on site of various sizes, breeds, and standards, stabled in three professional yards. Careers within the equine industry are multiple and varied. from racing and driving to endurance and dressage, horse trials and show jumping, there are many possibilities. In addition to this, the industry is supported by a large leisure market, which provides further extensive job opportunities.
Our first programme in this subject area is the FDSC Equine Science and Management, and Alex Baxter. Jonathan Cooper. Jemima Croft. Erin Dawson. Kiara Glover. Chelsea Hammond. Emma Hoff. Cassandra Iverson. Abby Mason. On to our BA Honours Programme in Equine Management now, and Lily Clark. Natasha Wild. Super, super blingy shoes. Ellie Bloor is our next prize winner. Ellie, if you'd like to take your spot on the Magic X, please. Tutor's comments. Ellie has been a dedicated and enthusiastic student throughout her time at Myerscough, always giving 100% to her studies as well as encouraging her peers. Ellie's dissertation, Investigating the Effect of a Topical Application on Hoof Growth, received high praise from the commercial company who sponsored the project at this year's Graduate Showcase. The winner of the Milrose and Ausker Award, Equine for 2022, is Ellie Bloor. Now we move on to the BSc Honours Programme in Equine Science now, and Alice Clark. Natasha Crompton. Caitlin Jones. Amelia Marsden. Imogen McKiernan. Kimberly Queegan. Molly Kate Singleton. Madeline Wottam's our next graduate. She's a prize winner. Madeline, if you'd like to face the audience, please. Tutors' comments. Maddie has been an outstanding student through her course, consistently achieving high grades, culminating in her first class dissertation, comparing the effects of manual and electrical massage therapy on horses' biomechanics. We wish her all the very best for the future. The winner of the Oak Hill Veterinary Centre Award for Equine for 2022 is Madeline Wottam. And the next subject area that we are celebrating success of this afternoon is teacher training.
Teacher training. In a job where no 2 days are the same, teaching has many benefits and people commit to teacher training to pass on their skills and passion for the subject, to inspire a new generation and to benefit from a rewarding career. Myerscough believes that great teaching changes lives for the better and our programmes develop the most exceptional educators possible. Through a combination of innovative classroom sessions, dedicated one-to-one tutorials and constructive observations, our trainees receive the best support to ensure they reach their potential towards becoming outstanding teachers. At Myerscough, each student on the programme is valued and supported to realise their full potential. This year's student teachers have worked extremely cohesively and have supported each other throughout their time on the programme. Their final achievement grades mirror the time, effort and commitment they put into the process. It means that Myerscough is now blessed with even more talented individuals working with students.
And receiving a certificate in education today, Neil Berrigan. Amanda Slater. Rochelle Soudan. Gemma Swindlehurst. And with the postgraduate certificate in education now, Helen Ashton. Emmeline Howarth. Bartholomew Lang. Iman Moenuddin. Terry Williams. And our next graduate, Laura Faraday, is a prize winner. Laura, if you'd like to face the audience, please. Tutor's comments. Laura is the consummate professional and has impressed all of those who've had a part in her teaching journey to date. That includes her subject mentor and course tutor. She's been committed to all parts of the PGCE with aplomb, and her portfolio was recently awarded exceptional by UCLAN's external examiners. In class, she's dedicated, collaborative and thoughtful, always keen to trial new ideas and take on board practical suggestions for how she can improve her delivery. The winner of the Trainee Teacher of the Year Award for 2022 is Laura Faraday. And the final subject this afternoon, of which we are celebrating our graduate success, is veterinary nursing and farriery.
Veterinary nursing and farriery. Myerscough School of Veterinary Nursing has been an established provider of education and training for veterinary nurses for more than 35 years. With approval from the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons, granted back in 1975. In this time, thousands of Myerscough students have entered the industry and gone on to highly successful careers. Veterinary nurses work alongside surgeons and provide a high standard of care and treatment for animals. This includes skilled supportive care for ill animals, as well as undertaking minor surgery, monitoring animals during anaesthesia, providing medical treatments, and carrying out diagnostic tests. Veterinary nurses also play an important role in the education of owners with regard to good standards of patient care. Our state-of-the-art Veterinary Nursing Training Centre opened in 2013 and provides fantastic teaching and research facilities, including fully equipped small animal theatres, and a radiography and dark room with ancillary equipment and ultrasound scanner. The centre also features anatomical, topographical and resuscitation models and rehabilitation wards. Farriery is an ancient craft, but a thoroughly modern trade. A farrier is a skilled craftsperson capable of shoeing all types of horses' feet and making shoes to suit all types of animals and working conditions. Modern farriers must have knowledge of the anatomy of horses' feet and legs, be able to work alongside vets, manage and handle horses, understand and meet the needs of clients, and successfully run their own business. Myerscough farriery students have access to some of the best facilities available, including 3 farriery workshops with 32 coke forges, a tiered seating demonstration area, mobile forge unit, and more than 50 horses on campus of various sizes, breeds, and standards. Myerscough also has a small pony stud and organises regular visits to the Lancashire Constabulary Mounted Division to shoe their police horses.
Our first programme in this subject area is the BSc Honours in Farriery and Andrew Cooper. Jeffrey Erie. Our next graduate, Georgina Swyzer, prize winner. Georgina, take your mark, please. Now, Georgina has 2 prizes. She won 1 in 2020 and another in 2022. So double the fun for you, Georgina. I'll be as quick as I can. Tutor's comments. This is for the 2020 award for your PhD diploma in farriery. Georgina is a committed and dedicated student in all aspects of the course. Her assignments have been exceptionally well written and laid out, and demonstrate the amount of wider reading she undertakes to gather the information conveyed. She pushed herself at every opportunity to improve and develop her practical shoemaking skills in the forge, and she challenged herself further, having made wooden templates of horses' feet to then practice fitting the shoes as she made them. All this hard work paid off, earning her a distinction overall and the 2020 Student of the Year. Stay there, Georgina. There is more. Because in 2022, she also won Student of the Year for her BSc Honours Programme. Tutor's comments here. Georgina has worked exceptionally hard through her two-year degree top-up, and her consistently high grades in all modules have given her a very well-deserved first-class honours degree. Georgina not only put many hours of hard work into her academic studies, but also came back on numerous occasions to use the forge to practice and hone her skills at the anvil. Like her fellow students, this was all achieved whilst running her own full-time farriery business. Georgina Swire, you've won awards for Students of the Year, both 2020 and 2022. We continue with the Certificate in Advanced Veterinary Nursing Dentistry and Caroline Bright. Alicia Richards. Onto the Certificate in Advanced Veterinary Nursing, Teaching, Coaching and Mentoring, and Whitney Ball. Marlus Baltas. Again, with super, super sparkly shoes. Christine Head. We move on to the FDSC program in veterinary nursing, and Tule Akajit. Abby Allinger. Morgan Bebb. Lauren Benson. Chloe Butler. Abigail Fraser. Ellie Giddens. Joanne Greenall. Amy Hardiker. Katie Kay. Jessica Kent. Charlie Kershaw. Jessica Kilner. Mary Kyle. Ellie McMahon. Katie Marston. Tegan McDowell. Sana Musa. Millie Motley. Michelle Picard. That's what buying extra tickets does, you see. You get louder. Olivia Palmer. Great boots as well, Olivia. Amelia Pearson. Louise Perrotts. Isn't here. It's Lauren Prescott. Abigail Pullen. Courtney Rawlinson. Laura Saxon. Victoria Scott. Isabel Shaw Cross. Emily Thornton. Samantha Tyrrell. Charlotte Wilkes. Lauren Williams. Jade Challoner is a prize winner. So Jade, if you would like to step forward onto the X. Tutor's comments. We are very happy to see Jade qualifying as a veterinary nurse today. Throughout the course, she has been a pleasure to have in the classroom, and she's graduating with some excellent marks in her final year modules, which is testament to her strong character and her academic ability. Jade has overcome a variety of personal challenges and setbacks to stand on this stage today, never once losing her kindness, genuineness, and honesty. This kind of dedication, resolve, and resilience embodies everything that a veterinary nurse strives for, and we wish Jade every success in the future. The winner of the 2022 Robert Allen Memorial Award goes to Jade Challoner. Amber Doran is next, and she's also a prize winner. Step forward, Amber. Tutor's comments. Amber has been an excellent student throughout her studies, consistently achieving high grades in both assignments and exams, and always working to the very best of her ability. Working diligently to complete her nursing progress log to an exceptionally high standard, Amber met all of the deadlines well ahead of time, demonstrating exemplary practical skills and leading her training practice to speak very highly of her as a valued team member. Amber's also been an absolute pleasure to teach during the program, willingly contributing to all taught sessions and sharing her knowledge and experience with her peers. Student of the Year for Vet Nursing is Amber Doran. We continue with the BSc Honours Programme in Veterinary Nursing and Georgia Hall. Alicia Lowe. Paige Moneypenny. Sparkly shoes are definitely the future. I must make a change on that next year. Felicity Corns is our next graduate. She is a prize winner. Felicity, step forward, please. Tutor's comments. Felicity has worked exceptionally hard throughout this BSc degree, undertaken alongside her full-time employment as a registered veterinary nurse. Her engagement with the course has been exemplary, earning her very well-deserved first-class honours. Her outstanding dissertation represented a pertinent topic within current veterinary practice, with Felicity being able to use her findings to positively influence client education within her workplace. We wish her every success in her continuing career. The winner of the Lorraine Allen Memorial Award for Vet Nursing for 2022 is Felicity Corns. And our final graduate this afternoon, last but by no means least, is also a prize winner. Michaela Davis, please step forward, step onto the Magic X, please. Tutor's comments. Michaela has worked very hard to achieve the well-deserved first-class honours in her BSc, undertaken alongside full-time employment as a registered veterinary nurse. She's engaged very well with all aspects of the course and has been a pleasure to teach. Michaela produced an excellent dissertation, which has allowed her to obtain a better understanding of the level of knowledge amongst vet nurses in relation to an important area of practice. And this will only serve to improve confidence levels and patient care. We wish Michaela every success throughout her career. A prize winner and graduating with a BSc honours in clinical veterinary nursing this afternoon, Michaela Davis. Michaela, the final graduate this afternoon. Let's have one last round of applause for all of our graduates. Thank you. Thank you very much to our Vice Principal, Stephen Downing-Clark, for doing the honours with the handing out of the scrolls as well. Stephen, thank you. I would now like to call upon Claire Roberts from the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons to lead our newly registered vet nurses in the reading of their oath. Claire. You can give her a round of applause as well if you wish.
It's a great pleasure and honour to be here with you today, celebrating all your graduations, but in particular veterinary nursing graduations for me. And I'm really proud and actually quite emotional and humbled to be leading you through your declaration to join the RCVS Register of Veterinary Nurses and admitting you as associate members of the college. The title of veterinary nurse is one to be proud of. Although veterinary nursing is a relatively young profession, it's come a long way since the original scheme of registered animal nursing auxiliaries, or RANAs, which was introduced back in 1961. You are joining a profession during an unprecedented period of positive change and growth. Please be proactive and engage with our profession. Be the catalyst of the changes you want and instrumental in shaping our future, because anything is possible. The work you have undertaken to get here today should not be underestimated. Along the way, you've passed numerous examinations, assignments, OSCEs. You've completed the RCVS Day 1 Skills for Veterinary Nurses. This is truly outstanding, and you should be extremely proud. Now it's time to reap the rewards and savour the results of the hard work. Today is a momentous day. With your admission to the RCVS Register of Veterinary Nurses, allowing you to legally practice as a veterinary nurse, abiding by the VN Code of Professional Conduct as an accountable professional. As veterinary nurses, you're an essential part of the veterinary team, working alongside your colleagues to ensure the health and welfare of your patients. You will make a positive difference on every shift you work. Do not forget that. I would now ask you to make the declaration. So veterinary nurses, please stand and repeat as a group each line after me. I promise and solemnly declare that I will pursue the work of my profession with integrity. And accept my responsibilities to the public, my clients, the profession, and the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons. And that above all, my constant endeavour will be to ensure the health and welfare of animals committed to my care. You can sit. Thank you. So, in the name of the Council of the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons, and by virtue of the power conferred upon them by the Royal Charter and by Act of Parliament, I do hereby admit you as associates of the said Royal College, and by the same power do confer upon the right to be styled Registered Veterinary Nurses, and to be known and deemed and recognised henceforth as duly qualified members of the veterinary nursing profession. I congratulate you all on becoming qualified registered veterinary nurses and wish you a satisfying, challenging and rewarding career.
A big thank you to Claire Roberts from the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons for doing our oath this afternoon. Claire, thanks very much indeed. Before we go any further, I'd just like to very quickly say a quick word for our outgoing head of Agriculture and Countryside, Craig Thompson. He's been with us for 20 years now, and unfortunately, Craig is leaving us for pastures new in the summer. Craig, thank you so much for everything that you've done for Myerscough over the years. We really appreciate it. Students, staff, colleagues, like, we all love you very much and we're all really, really going to miss you. So Craig, all the very best for the future, and can we have an enormous round of applause for him, please? I would now like to call upon Jemima Croft to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of the graduates who have received their awards this afternoon. Jemima.
Good afternoon to our chairman, college patron, principal, students, ladies and gentlemen, and honorary college fellow. My name is Jemima. I'm an FDSC equine graduate, and today I have the honor of addressing you all on behalf of all the graduates from Myerscough College here today. I'm not gonna lie, this speech was a bit rushed to write as I only got off my honeymoon 2 days ago. However, I've become a bit of an expert at last minute waffling thanks to many assignments, so I'm sure I've got this in the bag. It's worth mentioning at this point, I do actually have short-term memory loss and I completely forgot about today. I have no idea what I'm doing here, but the hats are a bit of a giveaway, I think. I wasn't aware I was doing this speech until a few weeks ago when I was asked by head of HE Equine, Charlotte Brigden, how my speech was going. When I questioned what on earth she was talking about, thinking I'd forgotten about yet another assignment, she told me, oh, well, somebody's nominated you. So in a panic, I rushed to Sue Schofield, someone who's very used to my forgetfulness, who said, oh yeah, actually I forgot this time. It was me who put you forwards ages ago, I meant to tell you. We narrowed it down to who likes talking and who wouldn't swear, so in the end we chose you. I can assure you a word I'm not allowed to use today came out of my mouth. When I look back at my time at Myerscough, my journey's been a bit of a strange one. As a part-time older student, my experience was totally unique, but gave me plenty of opportunities and different perspective to most people here. My first week at uni, however, was exactly the same as everyone else. By Friday, I was crying my eyes out to my partner, saying that I had no friends, I didn't understand anything, I'd got lost on campus every single day, I'd hidden in the disabled toilet on at least three separate occasions. I couldn't even tell you what a horse looked like at this point, and I was never returning ever, ever, ever again. He promptly told me to get a grip and think of the student loan hitting my bank account soon. After the first of many meltdowns, I soon made friends and began to remember what a horse looked like. I thought I learned how to do Harvard referencing, but 3 years later, my most recent assignment feedback sheet would say otherwise. I even went on a uni night out, which resulted in many things I wish I could forget, but Snapchat memories reminds me accountable and holds me accountable every year. A low point was definitely using a glow stick as a hula hoop and forgetting I can't walk. I'll let your imaginations figure out how that one ended. This was also the year we had a cyber attack at Myerscough and all the computers had red sticker dots on them. You could only use the green ones. You definitely could not use the red ones. Now, I'm not the most technically minded and apparently I'm colorblind as well as forgetful because the poor uni lecturers spent the entire time chasing me around telling me off for using the red computers. So apologies, Myerscough staff. It was most likely me that caused the delay in the IT recovery. Unfortunately, COVID arrived and Boris put us all in lockdown. All our lessons were moved online to Teams and we had a new classmate join us for the odd lesson in the form of Sue's cat. Lecturers tried to make lessons interactive by putting us into breakout rooms on Teams, which normally ended up with somebody accidentally losing internet connection or figuring out how to change the background to a picture of the galaxy. Assignments were made into theory-based essays. If you've ever tried to explain to a non-horsey person how to ride a hot, young-blooded competition horse, it basically was like that. By some miracle, we all managed to pull through and progress on to second year. By second year, Boris had changed his mind for the 10th time, and we were allowed back on campus in person. We had to wear masks and sit 2 metres apart, so for once, I was actually allowed to shout across the classroom. Because I was part-time, my second year was to be spread across 2 years, so I got to choose all of my modules that I wanted to do first. Naturally, I picked to do all the fun ones, and I felt very smug about that. Second year for me consisted of riding ponies, grooming ponies, riding more ponies, looking at ponies. I didn't really do a right lot of proper work. But COVID still wasn't done, so back online we went. Things ran a bit smoother this time, as everyone knew what to expect, and Sue's cat became a regular guest appearance. Along came third year, or second year part two for me. We were back on campus in person, this time for good. It was a difficult year for me, as I thought it'd be a really great idea to plan my wedding in the middle of my degree, and then I also bought an extra racehorse during winter, just for good measure. I also had to leave my friends I'd spent the past 2 years with and join the year below in order to finish my foundation degree. As my friends progressed onto dissertations and presentations, I had to do all the harder modules I'd put to one side last year, and I no longer felt very smug about that. It felt like first year again, thrust into a new environment with new people. At least this time I wouldn't get lost, as surely after 3 years I would know my way around. I went to my first lesson with plans of hiding in the background and ignoring everyone for as long as possible, because no one would know who I was and then it wouldn't be awkward. Unfortunately, I stayed true to form. I got lost en route. I crashed into a door on my way in my bright purple wheelchair, and I drew all the attention onto myself. I was pleasantly surprised to see a few familiar faces from the books team and soon made some new friends as well. My third or slash second year was hard, but very rewarding. I had to push myself out of my comfort zone in order to succeed, and I bonded with my current course mates over the struggle that is Minitab. I did my best to support my old course mates that battled through dissertation work and looked on fondly when they all celebrated handing day. I became the biggest hype man possible to my friends by sending 5-minute long voice notes, and I absolutely lived for that role. The people really are what make the degree, in my opinion. For me, there were a few standout moments across the years. First year riding group were unable to say anything other than come on for the duration of the lessons. Numerous people auditioned for Ben Atkinson's stunt horses with their impressive impromptu dismounts. Nearly throwing up during dissection lab sessions. Falling off lab stools due to still being slightly hungover from Stumble Tuesdays. Making horse digestive systems out of Play-Doh. The group chat that was predominantly used for panicking about exams and having very heated discussions on whether COVID was real or a hoax. That time, Jerry the horse nearly inhaled a pen, but we won't mention that. The equine department is full of academic individuals, I promise. There genuinely are many success stories from this year's graduates. My friend Alice, for example, went on to present her dissertation at Hartbury Student Conference this year and represent the university. She received approval from Dr. David Marlin and won the award for Best Undergraduate Oral Presentation. She's a very handy person to have on side as I go into my final year, I can promise you that. Many of this year's graduates have already begun careers in their chosen industries or gained places to do master's degrees up and down the countries, proving that dissertations aren't just full of waffle in order to meet a word count. This journey wouldn't have been the same without the lecturers supporting us along the way. I can't even begin to count the amount of emails I've sent to every single one of the equine lecturers that start with, "Hello, I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing and I'm panicking, help." The patience they've shown us is a real testament to their ability as teachers. A personal favourite of mine was the feedback on my recent research development assignment where I had to interpret a load of numbers and sums onto Minitab, and I went completely wrong, but I just rolled with it because I was in far too deep, and at this point there was no way back. Charlotte wrote, and I quote, "I think you got a little muddled there as there was some confusion over numbers and it wasn't quite right. Double check this next time." So polite, thank you Charlotte for softening the blow. In all seriousness, to the lecturers and staff here, equine or otherwise, thank you from all of us. We wouldn't have got this far without you dedicating your careers and your knowledge to helping us build and expand ours. Friends and family back home also play a massive part in us being able to complete our degrees. The encouragement and unconditional belief you have in us doesn't go unnoticed, and for that we thank you. Everyone's got something to say about Myerscough. As agricultural and land-based students, we're known in the community for many things, mostly for smelling a bit funky and taking over Preston Town on a Thursday night. But the truth is, Myerscough has a much greater effect on us all than that. For me personally, my time at Myerscough is the first time in 10 years of being disabled that I fully felt accepted for who I am. I've never been made to feel any different to anyone else. I've never been an oddity or a novelty. I've never even been a big deal. I've just been allowed to be me. Now, granted, that definitely isn't always enjoyed by everyone, but it's allowed me to grow in confidence and gain friendships that I now class as family. It's provided me with opportunities and opened doors for my career that otherwise would have been fully closed off. And I know that's something that all of us here have been able to experience in some way individually. To the class of 2022, we did it. Time to give yourselves a pat on the back and breathe. All the blood, sweat and tears were worth it. You've now got a stepping stone into your future and a stable foundation to fall back on if needed. I wish you all the best in your future endeavours and I can't wait to see how successful you're all going to be. I told you all at the start of this speech I was good at waffling and I think I've proven that, so I'll end it there. Thank you for listening.
Thanks very much indeed, Jemima, an absolute inspiration, I am sure you'll agree. So, honorary college fellow, chair, governors, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our graduation ceremony for this afternoon. But before we do close the event, no graduation would be complete without one certain tradition. So can I ask all of our students to please stand and remove your mortarboards, please. Friends and family and loved ones, this is a great chance for you to get your cameras and your phones ready. You can stand as well if you wish to get a better view. So we will do three cheers, and then on the count of three, we will throw our mortarboards high into the air. We will not injure anybody, take anybody's eye out. There'll be none of that. Somebody this morning got one in the basket above your heads. That perhaps could be a target for you. Who knows? Are we ready? Hip, hip. Hip, hip. Hip, hip. Three, two, one. Okay, graduates, if you could just sit down for a few more moments, please, once you've found your mortarboards. Is everybody okay? Thank you. Just have your attention for a few more seconds, please, graduates. May I take this opportunity to remind everybody that there is a post-ceremony reception for all of our student guests. That is in our marquee, in our beautiful college garden. So in a few moments' time, as you leave the hall, you'll be paraded back around, and then you'll come back across this stage. You'll leave via the doors to our left-hand side, and the staff outside will guide you into our college gardens where you can celebrate to your heart's content. All that remains for me is to say thank you so much for your attendance. Enjoy the rest of your day and, of course, have a safe journey home, however it is you're choosing to celebrate. Please now be upstanding, but remain silent for the returning procession of the College Mace, accompanied by the fabulous Gemma Louise Doyle once more.
Nascent dawn, to fly up into pain, never to afraid of stars. Thank you.
One last time, please, for Gemma Louise Doyle and the rest of our graduates this afternoon. Thank you very much. Well, that does conclude our ceremony this afternoon. Thank you very much for your attendance once again, and enjoy the rest of your celebrations, graduates. Thank you. Thank you.